Say what you want about Woody Allen, one movie a year? Whew. Mr. Allen seems to be on this kick of doing like one really good slash serious movie, and then immediately doing a much lighter slash sometimes usually not as good movie. Last summer brought us Blue Jasmine, which earned Kate Blanchett an Academy Award for Best Actress, which she totally deserved. The movie had lots of great performances, as well as a more dramatic, almost sad plotline. This year's Magic in the Moonlight is about as light and flighty as you can get. We've got Colin Firth, you know him, he's all...
Oh, hello, I'm terribly charming and I'm terribly British and I'll be taking over.
Doggy?
I'll be taking over since Hugh Grant's career is... I don't know what happened to him.
He plays a magician, well, a charlatan of a magician. He basically dresses up in yellowface for a living.
It was the 20s.
He's also a very cynical man, a man of reason. He knows there's no real magic or spiritualism in the world, but his best friend tells him that there is a girl who is a psychic, and an extremely gifted psychic at that, and she's played by Emma Stone.
Be still, my heart.
So Colin Firth is determined to prove that she is a fraud. There's just one problem. She's so pretty. The movie almost has a importance of being earnest sense of humor mixed with some very obvious Woody Allen themes. Colin Firth's character is constantly struggling between his own common sense and the fact that this girl is mystifying him. Things are revealed and the plot goes in some places that I wasn't really expecting, but I think that's also due to the fact that this script is a little all over the place. There is a great deal of humor, but mostly it stems from the characters acting a bit too farcical. It's the kind of humor we've seen in a lot of Woody Allen type comedies. It just never seemed to me that the actors were 100% comfortable in these situations. There is plenty to like here. I thought the movie worked really, really well up until probably like the first half. That's about when the trouble with the script starts appearing. But honestly, the film's light tone and its witty dialogue is actually pretty refreshing in this season of explosions and sequels and prequels and blah blah blah. If you're somebody who likes Woody Allen comedies or just period comedies set in the 20s, you're going to like this. It's certainly a flawed movie. Most of that has to do with the structure of the plot, but I still enjoyed every minute of it. This is definitely more of a style over substance sort of thing, so I give the movie a B. You know what? I give it a B plus. You keep making those movies, Woody Allen, until you literally can't anymore.